morning, and a very warm welcome to each one of you present here today. Venture Center is happy to host MEDHA 2019 in collaboration with BTech. I'm sure all of you are eagerly looking forward to the next 36 hours to see all your ideas take shape. We have a quick round of introductions of the organizing institutes. May I request Dr. Smita Kale, Associate Incubator Manager at Venture Center, to give us a brief overview of Venture Center.
Good morning, everyone. I welcome you all. So Venture Center is India's largest inventive enterprises incubator. We are registered as Section 8 company. We are a non-for-profit organization. We are open to all, but we are sector agnostic and aimed at startups with a strong science and technology background. We are hosted by CSR NCL, approved by NSTEDB and BIRAC, recognized by DSIR and DIPP, and being a charitable organization, we are eligible for CSR support. So our mission at Venture Center is to nucleate the new businesses and nurture the already existing businesses, which are technology and knowledge based actually, in India by leveraging the scientific and engineering competences of the different institutions in the region. So we all know that Pune is an educational hub. So we would like to leverage all those competencies of the Pune region, Maharashtra, and then India. So our key focus areas are inventive enterprises, spin-offs from R&D organizations, biotech, biomed startups, social innovation and enterprises, energy and environment ventures, and material science-centric products. So we are governed by a board of directors. Our board of directors include Director of CSIR NCL, Professor A.K. Nangia, Shri H.K. Mittal from NSTEDB, Shri Pramod Chaudhary, who is the founder and president of Praj Industries, Professor A.T. Kushre from IITB, Professor K.N. Ganesh, who was earlier the director of ISEP Pune, now he is at ISEP Tirupati, Dr. Satya Dash from PATH, and our founder president director, Dr. Premnath. So some of the accomplishments, we have been recognized nationally and internationally. So recently we were among the top two in ISGF Innovation Award, and we won the Smart Incubator of the Year. This is my colleague Soma receiving the International Award for Incubator of the Year at Taiwan. And then we were awarded from President of India, that's National Award for TBI in 2015. So what do we offer at Venture Center is, we understand that mentoring is very critical, especially for early stage startups. So we provide advice and mentoring services for all these early stage startups to help them raise fundings, either in the form of fellowships, grants or seed funding. So we have a lot of, we are implementation partners of a lot of fellowships and grant in aid programs, and we host 3 seed funds at Venture Center. We provide infrastructure, that is dedicated lab spaces and office spaces, as well as we have our own scientific and prototyping facilities. So we have all high-end analytical instruments, shared chemistry labs, bio labs, as well as tinkering lab for electronics. We help startups for technology commercialization. So we have an intellectual property facilitation center where we have patent agents which help startups in this service. And then for the products which need to enter regulated markets, so we have a regulatory information facilitation center for that. We have a very rich library with a lot of informative business books. We keep running events throughout the year, that is talks, trainings, technical workshops. These events actually provide a good network for good platform for networking actually. And we also have in-house service providers whom we call as ecosystem partners. So coming to some statistics, right now we have 77 startups here as resident incubatees, and till date we have supported 115 resident incubatees. Overall, since inception, we have supported almost 350 startups. Our largest incubatee has raised more than 100 crores of investments. We have 50 plus patent families being filed. Most of our founders are from very rich work experience or are from very reputed Indian or international universities. And we take a pride in telling you that 30% and more are actually women founders. 90% of the beneficiary companies which have been supported by Venture Center are still active till date. So these are some notables. We are the first TBI under CSR, CSIR. These are the awards which I have already mentioned. We are home to BIRACS Bio Incubator, that's BioNest, and we are one of the BIRACS Regional Bio Innovation Centers. So there are three in country, we are one of them. We have recently been awarded by a MEDHA Center of Excellence grant, with which we are going to set up a new facility which will double our capacity. And we are also implementation partner of many of the fellowship programs, as I mentioned, MEDHA EIR is one of them. So these are the glimpses of the resources and facilities, library, the IP facilitation center, our shared labs, and all the analytical facilities. And these are the glimpses of the events which we run throughout the year. Coming to the domains which we support, so more than 60% are in healthcare, that is biomed, implants, detection, diagnostics, 10% in clean energy, environment, 11% in agro, industrial biotechnology, 10% in ICT, electronics and engineering, and 8% others. So these are the different clusters which have emerged at Venture Center. So there are 8 of them, and these are the logos of the startups which are currently the resident incubatees. And then we have a class of ecosystem partners here, which are the in-house service providers. So the mission of Venture Center is very much aligned with all the national missions of India, and we, along with our startups, are contributing towards these. So lastly, our flagship program is Lab to Market program, where we empower the scientists from academic and research organizations to actually commercialize their research. So that is called as a spin-out. So these are the 9 companies which have been supported by Venture Center. So I request you all, please connect with us on social media. And when you all share your experiences about MEDHA on social media, don't forget to tag us. So these are our social media handles on Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn. Please stay connected and stay updated with our events. So that's it. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Smita. May I call upon Dr. Rupesh, the Senior Executive Officer at BETIC, to please give us an overview of BETIC and to also run us through the schedule for the next 2 days.
Thank you very much. So, good morning, everyone. So let me quickly run through what is going to be MEDHA. And MEDHA stands for Medical Device Hackathon. It's usually a weekend event, so you all here on a Saturday morning. And by end of Sunday evening, 6 o'clock, you all be free. So that's the time. But next 30 hours are ours. Okay. So literally, you will see that you will not be touching your phones, you will not be calling friends. Maybe family is okay, but that's how intensive it's going to be. But why are we doing this? I'll give you a background of why this is happening. India, if you really look at it, there are many diseases. Pick one and you can still make your career, and many people impacted because of that. We have about 14,000 healthcare problems. So don't be finicky about only choosing one problem. Fall in love with your problems, not solutions, in that manner. So pick one problem, I'm sure you're going to make something out of it. And we have enough of those. So any of you recognize these things? So the doctors, it's okay, but the engineers, have you seen healthcare devices, medical devices? Just name a few. Any of that? Okay, fair enough. So at least you can recognize them, right? The reason why we are doing this, one of the primary reason is India, if you see, these are recent numbers which is just come in, and we have about a market of 48,000 crore, okay, and out of which 80% of the devices are imported by India, medical devices. So what is the amount if it comes to almost up to 40,000 crore as a country, we are bleeding. The reason being, we are not developing our devices. Who should be developing those devices? Who can develop those devices?
Us.
So if you really see that we can develop it, we should develop it, but we don't do it. And there are some reasons why we don't do it, or we have not been able to do it. And we had different focuses as a country earlier, but it's certainly a big sector that we should look at it. Now the other part comes in, that what happens if we import. But if you look at these numbers, so the healthcare expenditure, US is 18%, India is just 5%, and US has about $7,500. So even if you take an US imported device and even reduce the cost to 1/10, still it is going to be expensive for an average Indian. So just importing the existing device and making cheap still does not work out for India because of the spending. Now I'll give you the reason, one of the reasons why things are good and slightly grey. So Indian medical device sector, if you see, the West is bombarding it with quality. So whenever there is a healthcare problem, you need the best of the quality. And Indian devices compared to Western, we have always said that something which is made outside India or is imported is supposed to be good. So that gets hampered. From the East, the low cost comes in. So made in China or other things are always going to be low cost. So the Indian medical device is already suffering these from two things. On top of that, now we have medical device regulations which have just come in 2018 January, which means that anything which was not as per the good quality or not tested is going to be difficult to be sold in market. So that is another regulatory aspect which comes in. But does that mean everything is grey and gloomy? No, there is some silver lining. All our doctors who you would be seeing here today and tomorrow and the problem videos, they have also realized that doesn't matter high quality implants or products or devices or low cost, still they need something which is better, safer, high quality, reliable, affordable and adaptable. These are the requirements which still exist for most of these devices which are imported. Not everything which is imported is suitable for Indian population. Not everything that is imported is suited for Indian anatomy or Indian physiology or the Indian processes that we follow. So that actually makes it not very suitable for Indian population. That means that there is a gap, there is a need, and that's from the clinical side. There is other advantage and silver lining that we have, and that is that we are supposed to be good at certain aspects of technology as a country, as the young engineers, what we are. We are good at 3D printing CAD/CAM, we are good at sensors and robotics, IoT, medical imaging, and these fortunately are the ingredients that are necessary for medical device innovation. So we are not very far off from any other developed country in these aspects, which means that we do have a chance that we are good at something and this is what is needed. So we can actually develop this industry and we could be able to solve our problems. So what do we need is probably things that are not just manufactured in India, but also developed in India. So manufactured in India is going to create jobs, but developed in India is actually going to create high value jobs, and the value that is going to be created is going to be large in that terms. Now this all can be solved through one common aspect, and that's the middle word you can see is product innovation. Making cheaper version of existing does not work out. Medical device regulations, and by the time you become big, somebody is going to sue you for copying something. So you put all in the hard work, hard effort, medical device industry, hardware, it's again difficult, and finally somebody says you have copied something what we have done. That's why innovation is the only path that could help us take it there. And how do you do innovation? Probably one of the routes which most of us have shied away is collaboration. So pick up any medical device and you'll see that various streams of engineering and medical have to work together to make that happen. So you take a blood pressure monitor, you need electronics engineer, software engineer, mechanical engineer, a doctor, a material science, all people working together to make sure that one device happens. And that's why it is very necessary that we actually work together on that. Now, if you really see all these fields working together for product innovation, it needs collaborative team efforts, which as a country we have been struggling, but I think it's time that we now start doing that, start coming out of our comfort zones. So engineer only visits a doctor when he's ill, and a doctor only visits an engineer probably in the whatever you have, school reunion or something at that stage. So that's where we are trying to see that maybe we need to start meeting each other more, try to understand each other's problem and try to see if we can solve problems from other domains which are out of our comfort zone. So I'll just give you a briefly background. BETIC stands for Biomedical Engineering Technology Incubation Center. It's a small shed that you see between some banyan trees at IIT Bombay. It's a very humble lab. The primary reason why we built this was to bring doctors, engineers, researchers, entrepreneurs together. That was the primary focus. And why do we bring them is the vision was to get ideas converted to inventions, to innovation, and try to create an impact. So it was not about just research papers or patents or finally whatever we have done, does it reach the people it was designed for, and can we create an impact because of that. So impact can be social or impact can be economical also. So there are two aspects to impact which can be taken care. And how did we define our mission was that get a problem from the doctors, clinicians, physicians, which are bedside problems, then try and create some engineering bench solutions, which is bench, bring them back to business and make sure it reaches back to the bedside. Unless we complete that, it's just something sitting in a lab or a prototype, and that's not going to be helpful for somebody. So to give you an overview of how we did that in the last 4 years, we have about more than 320 problems which we collected from various clinicians, physicians and doctors. And these were unmet clinical needs where they said, I wish there was a device which could do something. They were filtered. We made more than 150 proof of concepts of various devices, made more than 50 functional prototypes of various devices. And these are 16 of those devices which have reached the people it was designed for in some manner. So what you see is there are startup companies where the innovator themselves said that this was a good device, I worked with the doctors, I developed it, the prototype was fine, and now let's go ahead and make the business part of it so that we can actually reach to bedside. And these startups have made these products, and some of them are already in market now. The other aspect was, not every device means it's going to be a startup. Not every device means there is a business plan and a method of making sure that a company comes out of that one product. It may directly sit into somebody's basket of products, and who already has a distribution channel and network, it makes more business sense there. So what we have done is empowered Indian medical device industry by licensing these products to them and saying that, hey, we did the whole de-risking, everything is tried, tested, working, now just go ahead and manufacture this and make sure it is sold and reaches the people it was designed for. So if you see from probably stroke detection devices, glaucoma screening to diabetic foot, we are calling ourselves domain agnostic because these problems are not looking at people and saying that I need a mechanical engineer to solve me. This is something where you need people working together to solve. How we did that? These are some of the beautiful faces. Each of the photo either has an engineer and a doctor, and in some photos you will even see a patient where whatever innovations were made actually have reached to the users in that aspect. And we have many more such pictures. So just media coverage, media started noticing, but that also helps because these innovators started getting more platforms where the government started noticing them, they started calling them, as in all these helps for you to make sure your devices, innovations get promoted to the right places. Now this is the start of it, the hackathon. We have three hackathons. So first one was done last weekend. It was in Mumbai. It was a very good successful event where we had 40 participants like you, 10 doctors, 10 mechanical engineers, 10 electronics and 10 designers. They worked for 30 hours, it is possible, and they actually developed 10 proof of concepts, and probably you would be seeing them noticing around in some newspaper that at Hafkins Institute during MEDHA hackathon one device was developed, as in one or other device. And that could happen here also, and I'm sure there will be coverage for Pune also. So save your lines what you're going to talk in case somebody comes and interviews you. So don't give away what and how it works. Probably you can sell what problem it solves. So be careful what you're doing. So what we'll be doing is watching some videos which are problem statements which we have carefully done, and I'll go into detail of the event also. Some of the pictures of hackathons which have happened earlier similarly. So this was the first hackathon which was in Bangalore ISC. This was in KJ Somaiya in 2017. You'll see this interaction phase where it's beautiful, where people start brainstorming, start creating prototypes. Then this was in July itself at DJ Medical. So that was just about 2 years back in the medical hospital, medical college. We had a hackathon where engineers were coming there and they were developing some proof of concepts. This was again in a medical college in Wardha, and this was in Kolhapur where we had a very good response. And there are many such pictures. So this was at KJ Somaiya last year. This is at Nagpur again last year. And each of these picture is literally, you'll see devices which look at the kind of devices and prototypes which were built. So the first prototype you build, you think you have solved, then second, the third, you start moving closer and closer towards a prototype which starts looking like the doctor says, yeah, this maybe I can try and see something. Because the first one you make with hanging wires and LED just glowing, you think that that problem is solved, whereas doctors will not even teach, touch that. So however, we still try to move from one to second to third, and we'll do that. So far now, VETIC has kind of grown in a manner where it started at IIT Bombay, and we had College of Engineering Pune and VNIT as the two primary partners. So mandate for VETIC was to get people together and develop few devices. But it has grown to an extent where now we have multiple partners who have joined in this battle of developing innovative medical devices. We have Rai Soni College from Nagpur, Sumaya from Mumbai, MIT, EDT in Pune. We have Dr. Renu Vyas, and Symbiosis also has joined in. And we have two beautiful partners who are helping us, Venture Center and Science. So these innovators who develop, we take it to the edge where we say now it's a working prototype, it is tried, tested, but you need business mentoring, and we have beautiful mentoring done by Sign and Venture Center so that these companies take forward. We also have medical colleges and hospitals who have joined in as partners with us now. So it's a beautiful network of all such people working together. We have BJ Medical and a good representation today and tomorrow as well coming in. So if you have doubts about your problems, I'm sure these doctors, surgeons, clinicians will be available for any kind of answers for you. They've committed. So the only worry is for us is that if they're here, there is some patient who is going to wait, but I think we'll have to do some trade-off someday like that. We also have three partners which are government. So Maharashtra government signed an MOU with BETIC where BJ Medical, JJ Hospital and St. George Hospital Dental, they also are saying that we need a BETIC cell or innovation cell for medical devices in one of these campuses. And AMTZ, again something you can look up, is Andhra MedTech Zone, which has come in Andhra Vizag. It's a beautiful 270 acres of medical device innovation manufacturing hub, which has all the facilities that are necessary for existing manufacturers to scale up their things. So it's something that you can always look up. And we have some MOU right now with Gujarat government also going on. So you must have received the schedule right now. It is roughly something where at this point, 10 o'clock, we'll start with the problem overviews, the 18 problems that we have collected from various doctors, clinicians, physicians, who have tried to concise the problem in 2 minutes and give you a brief, what is the domain, what is the problem, and what are the limitations of current solutions. So once that happens, so you get to know what are the problems that you would like to work. Then you come back and start forming teams. So that's the second task, that each of you will have a team at the end of probably 3 o'clock. You should be in a team and you will have a team. So far it has not happened in probably 8 hackathons and 5 camps that we have done, that teams have not been formed. So that will happen, and then we'll take you through the whole pathway. You'll have mentors who will help you. How do you do stepwise, strategically, structurally, innovation in the shortest time possible? And that can be done. So we'll do brainstorming, we'll remove some mental blocks, roadblocks, and try to come up with early proof of concepts. We'll have beautiful material which can be used, and that will be for your prototyping kits. And if you see, there is, which means it's going to continue even after that. So there will come an announcement at 3 o'clock in the night that anybody wants to go home. At 4 o'clock it will happen, probably 5 o'clock it happens. So this will continue, so be prepared. So keep your glucose monitored and oxygen. So these are the only two things that you need. Next day, we will try to give you a presentation guideline. Each team will actually come to a stage where there will be jury members. We'll have doctors and other members of juries who are going to be part. You'll have a presentation where each team will come and present for 5 minutes. And in that 5 minutes, please do not consider it's going to be a presentation like a research presentation or seminar presentation or a thesis presentation. It's a pitch. You're going to say, what was the team? What was the problem? How did you solve it? And how are you going to take it forward? These are only 3-4 things that you'll be talking in that presentation. And after that, one of the most important part is going to be the results here. I'll tell you, for whatever I've seen so far in hackathons, each of you has the equal chance of winning the prize or being the winner there, which means that what happens after winning is that you have to be prepared for your acceptance speech. You must have seen Oscars, it literally happens like that. And you have to be prepared, because then you can't go there and say, I thank my mom, dad, grandmother. So you have to be prepared from now onwards. What is that one line or two line you are going to talk about when you actually are standing here and holding your winning prize there? So you will be working towards it. So just a pictorial path of how, these are some of the videos, this is just representative. You'll have your own 18 problems. You have a sheet, everybody got a sheet about the problem statements. Those are roughly what the problems indicates. That is not the problem statement. It is not by the letter that is what is supposed to be. We'll show you the videos, the doctors will be here. They'll also explain you slightly if you have not understood. We keep it very efficient, and in 2 to 3 minutes you should be able to understand the videos. These videos will be given back to you if you want to watch them later. Then we'll have team formations, probably speed datings, or there will be some kind of immediate reaction that what kind of people I need. I'm a mechanical engineer, I don't need mechanical engineers, I need to talk to the other three kinds. So you'll have to be very quick on your feet and start interacting with such people. We'll use probably outside area to interact, lunch, and this will happen as there are no free lunches. During lunch also you'll be networking and making sure your teams are working. Once this happens, you have all different kinds of people. So make sure during team formations, you have all the four kinds. Each of you have a color given. So I think doctors are green, and probably electronics and biomedical is blue, mechanical and design. Design is purple probably, and mechanical is brown. I don't know why, but that's how we just found one color. And these four people, make sure your team has all these four colors. Okay, so that's simple to understand. And the more varied your team is, the more diverse your team is, the better outcome you will have during your brainstorming and the innovation that you'll be able to bring out. You've seen the Ebola suit. Any of you have heard about Ebola suit? Yeah. So do you know they got all kinds of doctors, engineers, scientists, and there was one member who actually gave a very key away innovation part in that. And what kind of person was that? Anybody guess? It was a tailor. Okay, so never underestimate who can be contributing towards solving a problem. So the more the varied the team it is, the better the outcome is going to come out of it. Once you have these brainstormings, you will have your creative ideas. We'll also show you how it is possible that we can generate huge amount of ideas, and how do you actually select the right ones to come to a conclusion. That also is a part of an exercise. How do you do communication? Probably from the cave drawings, what we have done till today, drawing or sketching or visual is a communication which does not need a language, and we'll try to help you in doing that as well. And I think prototyping, there was a session yesterday also, and Dr. Premner probably would share some more light on that. So these are some of the kits and how you build. So if you see one of the professors there, so if he can stay awake for 4 nights till 4 o'clock and he's 55 plus, I think we are fair about, we all are young here, maybe anybody more than 50? Okay, so we can still do that, right? So, and at the last day he was still standing tall and fine, and so it is possible that we can do something like that, prototyping. So this is the first view of each team we'll get. So once you form your teams, you'll get a prototyping kit. It's all sorts of basic stuff that you get, from straws to tapes to pins and needles to whatever you can. But this is a basic kit which each team gets. This is just a representative. Every year we keep on adding and removing things from this. The second kit you'll have, rather second station, there are three stations which you have. One is arts and craft material. What is necessary for building your prototype, you can build from this. Anybody guesses how much time or duration was required for making Google glasses? Years? Months? So it was about less than 24 or 48 hours when actually the first proof of concept for Google Glasses was built, right? So you have cardboard, card sheets which you can use. A proof of concept is different than a prototype, and a prototype is different than a product. So here we'll be somewhere in between POC and prototype. There will be a mechanical station where you have tools. So people who can use it, please use it very safely. There are safety gears which will be around. If you can't use it, there will be mentors or volunteers who will help you use these tools also. And there will be an electronic station. So art station, mechanical station, and electronic station. So electronics, you'll have soldering station, all the sensors that are necessary and electronics components. To an extent, the doctors feel that at the first stage that, okay, we define the problem, we help understand these engineers that this is what is the problem. But they have started building now, what do I do? So I've had doctors, participants who at middle of night said, I can solder, I've learned how to solder. Anybody needs soldering, and all night he was soldering. Okay, for all the teams he was helping, and so that is the kind of environment we'll be into. So please do not see that my role is done and I'm going to sit in a corner. That's not going to happen. And then last table that we'll have is a treasure chest. So this is all kinds of stuff that will be there at that station. Broken CD drives, to broken cameras, to things that were put out by somebody and we just gathered them, where we think that something of that can be used during your prototyping. And during the night, there is going to be some nightlife. Pune is supposed to have beautiful nightlife in that manner also. So any of your birthdays, or just let us know if you want to play music, you want to sing a song, you want to present anything. This all starts happening after 2 o'clock. So try and see if you prepare your slides and videos well in time. Make some good videos of when it is working. What works at 12 o'clock in the night does not work at 4 o'clock in the morning. Your batteries drain out, your LEDs blow out, things start happening. So when it is working, capture it. You can always have a better version of that video, capture it. And this is how a typical presentation, you'll have the screen, you'll have your prototype, and you will not be demonstrating your prototype to any of the jury. The prototype is going to be sitting there. Your video and presentation is your pitch. You're not going to show how it works. That has to be captured in your video itself and photos. So that's the acceptance speeches, so please be ready. We will have, I think Professor Ahuja is going to be there on the last day as well. So please be prepared. And just to conclude, kind of, so videos, team up, create, present. And these are some of the partners who are there. In Pune, you will have Venture Center, who is actually gracefully hosting this, and we thank for that. College of Engineering, Pune, MIT, Symbiosis, BJ Medical. So you will find members of their teams, volunteers from them, faculty from them, who will be around you. So do not hesitate to ask that, okay, I don't know what is the physics behind this or electronics behind this. Or there will be somebody around who may be able to help. What is the chemistry, the bio? You ask and something will come out of it. So do ask for that. So this project is funded by Rajiv Gandhi Commission and also by BIRAC. And the CAD is powered by Autodesk. So we have an Autodesk representative here, Mr. Ramesh. And you must have had the webinar a few days back. So in case doctors don't know how to do 3D modeling, there was a webinar and there is a software which will be available free of cost to all of you during the session. So you can use that. And there will be a volunteer from their side also who will help you do CAD modeling. So in case you can sketch, he'll do the 3D modeling and help you with that also if necessary. So we are trying to give you the right tools and empower you, so your creativity should not be in hurdles. So I'll thank the whole participants for being here on time. Thanks for the host institute and partner institute to give a very good kickstart now. And let's hope, I'll come back during the problem videos, but let's hope you have a beautiful next 30 to 35 hours. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Rupesh. I'm sure all the participants are already feeling charged up and motivated for the hours to come. So let's keep that up. May I request Dr. Prema to quickly give us his views on prototyping, so that will help you all ahead.
I think first I'll welcome all of you as a host out here, and welcome especially to all the partners listed here. I think something like this is only possible through partnerships. I must also point out we are very grateful that BIRAC is supporting this activity. What we have done is we are running something called a BIRAC Regional Bioinnovation Center. Under that, we organized yesterday's ideation session, followed by these 2 days of hackathon. You do the real ideation, hands-on, and prototyping here. What we thought was we'll precede it with some principles of how large companies do ideation, and not necessarily using a deductive model of ideation, but more of methods which are more inventive, which is very different than deductive. And there are many other techniques which we tried to cover yesterday as well. In fact, people have developed systematic methods to try and think through ideation, but unfortunately none of that is taught in colleges or universities. So that is something which we tried yesterday. Dr. Shankar from Mahindra's was here yesterday to discuss some of those methods as well. I hope some of those will come handy. Okay, let me also just briefly say, I'm very delighted that this hackathon is happening out here. I have many reasons to be very happy. First of all, I want to tell you that for many of you, this will probably be your first introduction to thinking through new ideas, and especially in the medtech field, right? And I wish when I was younger I could do something like that. By the way, I happen to be myself a medtech product developer, right? To me, the really exciting thing about this field is the real satisfaction of seeing a product in use. Okay, so I've been fortunate. Some of my work has ended up in the market. There are some products in the orthopedic space, some in the maxillofacial implants, which are in the market today and in use. Of course, it's a very challenging journey. It is not everybody's cup of tea, and it starts with a real commitment to the end product in use. So it's very exciting. The creative part is the early part when you come up with the ideas, and then the real, you know, work which takes you all the way to the market begins, and that's not trivial, right? And it gets difficult for the reason that these are medical products. You need to be sure that things are working fine. These have to go through regulatory processes. There are certain standards of manufacturing, quality, and so on and so forth, which also means that your cost goes up, your risks go up, and which of course means that you have to have a larger game plan. But the reason I'm telling you this is not to discourage you, okay? Because I'm in it myself, so I'm telling you that it's worth the journey, right? But I think the drive for most people in this field comes from the fact that there is an end point over there of a product in use, okay? And the satisfaction of seeing it in use, right? So if you keep that in the back of your mind while you're doing your work, you'll probably enjoy this journey a lot more, right? Incidentally, we are hosts to a lot of medtech companies, although we are not a little sector agnostic in that sense, but there's a lot of interest in health, and there's a lot of medtech interest currently. So almost 50% of our startups work in the healthcare space. Okay, and as Ms. Smita mentioned, these are all inventive startups. So we are looking at those which are knowledge intensive. There's an element of novelty in what they are doing, which also means that the path is also quite difficult, right? And there are many things you have to put in place. So we'll show you some of that as well. This place we have built it over a period of time. In fact, very shortly, we are going to launch a clean room facility, which will be CDSCO approved for clinical trial samples, which will come out right from here. So we are progressing in multiple directions. So, of course, the medtech connection and my own personal connection, I'm very happy that all of you are here and that you're thinking about this. The second angle is the fact that Professor Ravi, Rupesh, and Bentik have been doing such a wonderful job focusing on this whole sector. I'm very happy that they are doing it and trying to scale it up in such a way. I have a little, I happen to be an IITB alum, so I have a greater interest in playing along with the team. But that said, I think the work is fantastic. Okay, this also fits beautifully into what we are trying to do for the Bairac Regional Bioinnovation Center, where we have announced something called Venture Base Camps, which are basically 3 to 4 day activities where we focus on only one thing, which an entrepreneur might be struggling with at any given time. Okay, so in the past we have run something, for example, only focused on regulations, right? So the hope is that it's like a base camp. That means you start, before you start your journey, you prepare at the base camp, right? And the idea is to chalk out all the details right there so that you know what you are doing after that. So regulation is one of them. IP and technology, how do you do your technology strategy, is another. Fundraising is yet another, right? And many other things like that. This is the earliest stage one that we are doing, which is ideation, in that sense. So we're grateful to Bairac for helping us with some support, because all of this does take some effort and some resources to make that happen. We are home to a BIRAC bio incubator as well, and thanks to that, you'll have access to some of my colleagues here today. Incidentally, besides business mentoring, we have our we have a tinkering lab here, and a, what we call a proto shop, that actually is a little. It's also meant for guys who are trying to take it ahead. So it includes facilities which relate to, you know, sterilization, packaging, many other things as well, not just the prototyping. The prototyping is also an integral part of it. So that's another resource that will be available. There are also other experts in our team who have specialized in specific things. So you'll have a chance to interact with them as well. Last couple of points before I close. I just want to tell you that just give you a little bit of a quick perspective. Ideation, as far as ideation is concerned, the way we think about many of these technology development ideas in Venture Center is that your idea is about matching a problem to a solution, right? Sometimes problem comes from somewhere else, the solution toolkit that you put together comes from somewhere else, and the person who puts it together can be also somebody else, okay? And all this can happen at different time frames also. The problem was defined 10 years back, there was no solution. A part of the solution was defined 10 years back and there was no problem to solve, right? And then everything was put together by somebody else, right? And this whole act of just the ideation process is actually the, it's a creative and exciting part, but it's tricky also. I normally show a picture where I show that the same set of dots, you know, different people will connect differently. Somebody sees it as a bunch of dots, somebody joins it with straight lines, you know, and somebody sketches out a face in it, right? It's the same dots connected differently. And that's where your creativity comes in when you're building some of these ideas out, right? So these are just parts of the puzzle, the problem, the solution toolkit, and putting it all together into the idea is what the next step is. But that's the exciting part, right? After that, you have to progress it further. I hope many of you will do that as well. So you're doing a proof of concept, an alpha prototype today maybe. At least the concept is clear in your mind, you know what you're trying to do. It may not be what will be the final thing, but you can try visualizing it and then progress it gradually to a product at the end of the road. We're fortunate also to be, we are supporting quite a few startups which have emerged from the BETIC hackathons. There are BIG grantees, Biotech Ignition grantees, and we have mentored them to sort of begin their startup journey. And of course, there's a long way to go as well after that. And we are happy that we are doing that, and we are happy to support you as well as this happens. Point which I want to also leave with you is when you think of prototypes in the very beginning, it will be an idea and you are trying to realize it, right? As you go ahead, you will find that the journey becomes one of you making claims and then designing things, either prototypes or experiments, to prove those claims. So every version of your prototype becomes an act in listing claims and then showing that that claim is indeed true or will work or is feasible, right? So it's another way of thinking about prototyping, where every version of your prototype works on a claim and tries to show that that is possible, right? So a doctor has given you, or a clinician has stated a problem. Now you're working on a prototype, you've made a decision that, oh, this will work, right? Following that, you're progressively asserting or progressively stating claims and then saying that it indeed works, right? So if you're building a diagnostic, the first claim you might make is that I can detect this using this technique. But, you know, later stages, you might want to make a claim saying that I can detect it with this kind of sensitivity, right? This kind of specificity, that I can do this better than the next product that is there in the market, and so on, right? And that would be your progression of prototypes, which will demonstrate that you have something which is headed to the market eventually. So again, I welcome you, and please feel free to reach out to my colleagues in Venture Center. They're a great team. We are almost 35 people strong out here, and including a lot of technical experts as well, besides the people who are doing actual mentoring of startups. So they're putting a great effort to put all this together along with the VETIC team, and I'm very happy to have all of you here. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Premna. With that, we come to the conclusion of the first session for today. We'll now have a short tea break in the cafeteria. I request all of you to please assemble back sharp at 11 a.m. over here, and we will proceed to the next session. Thank you.